Well, meanwhile, the government has so far recovered over 300 million shillings out of the 615 million shillings that was erroneously sent to vulnerable beneficiaries. The Minister of Gender, Betty Amongi, told the Joint Committee of the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament that Airtel Uganda, which disbursed this money by mistake, has stepped up efforts to recover the balance. Now, we are also told that the mobile money lines of beneficiaries in question have been blocked.
Facing off with the Joint Public Accounts Committee, which is probing lists of Nabanja cash beneficiaries, the Minister of Gender, Betty Amongi, confirmed that 6,011 beneficiaries received double payments amounting to an extra pay of 615 million shillings. This was due to shortcomings of Airtel system.
On 16th July 2021, we received a bunch of 25,847 beneficiaries, of which 16,011 were Airtel subscribers and 9,836 were MTN subscribers. The MTN subscribers were paid as always, seemingly, though we experienced a couple of issues with the Airtel payment system.
Amongi, who represented the Prime Minister, reported progress in recovering this money, saying over 373 million shillings have been recovered, leaving 242 million shillings pending.
Airtel was immediately, 15 minutes after completing this, notified by both email and phone, and they assured the bank that they were going to address the issue. Airtel had system challenges and only managed to reverse shillings 91,151,040 on the same day of 16th July 2021. On the 20th of July 2021, another reversal of 275,323,821 shillings was processed. And on the 21st of July 2021, another reversal of 5,606,892 was processed.
She also explained that Airtel has blocked all mobile money lines of beneficiaries whose extra pay is yet to be reverted, and assured the committee that the balance will be recovered within 2 days.
The bank called today to confirm that the number of recovery from those subscribers of the 240 something, they have recovered more money, and they have assured us that in the next 3 days they would have finalized recovery. Of course, to protect the money from not being withdrawn, the Airtel decided to block the numbers of those who received twice.
However, MPs questioned procedure under which the Minister of Gender came to take charge of this relief program instead of the line Ministry of Disaster Preparedness and Relief.
You are aware that town clerks are supervised directly by the Ministry of Local Government. And it's quite surprising that the Ministry of Gender became the line ministry to direct town clerks on work to do. I find that, Chair, a little irregular, and it's also surprising that the town clerks, who are supposed to be supervised by the mayors were completely left out of this exercise.
You're running away from this as a disaster. But I still think it is a disaster that falls under Article 249 of the Constitution. And if you read with me, it states, Disaster Preparedness and Management Commission. We are required to establish a commission. And two, we are required to bring in Parliament a law.
The minister made her time explaining why political leaders were left outside the process of generating and verifying lists of the vulnerable poor people.
The PS himself states that this exercise will be supervised by designated ministers, area members of parliament, and resident district stroke city commissioners. He states it in his communication. Strangely though, when he's giving copies, the MPs are left out, are not copied into the communication.
For the case of Kampala, I understand that the Lord Mayor and his executive was supposed to be part of the task force. But what they did, through the office of the RCC, they blocked the elected leaders from being part of the task force that was supposed to decide who should access these funds.
The committee has tasked government to consider extending the residual funds to private school teachers in rural areas which were not considered in the main program.